that of WBCs are there. WBCs are of two types, basically granulocytes and agranulocytes. Granulocytes again are of three types and agranulocytes of two types. So total five types of WBCs are there. So can you see, this is blood containing various types of cells, RBCs, the five type of WBCs and platelets. So total seven types of cells are there, RBCs, five type of WBCs and platelets. What I mean is this, just a second, give me a second. So what I mean is this, so there are five type of cells in blood vessels. It is RBC, it is platelet and the five type of WBC. The five type of WBC, the three of them are granulocytes, that is neutrophil, eosinophil and basophil. Why they are known as granulocyte? Because they have granules in their cytoplasm, of course, that's why they are known as granulocyte. And few of them are agranulocytes, they do not have granules in their cytoplasm, that's why these are known as agranulocytes. So these are monocytes and lymphocytes. So neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil, they have granules in their cytoplasm. The color of granule is different in each of them. The color of granules in neutrophil is purple, pink or purple. In eosinophil it is red, brick red, bright or brick red color. In basophil it is dark blue or black color. So the color of granules is different, composition of granules is different. And agranulocytes are monocytes and lymphocytes. These do not have granules in their cytoplasm. Of course, these are known as agranulocytes. So total seven types of cells are there, RBCs, platelets and the five type of WBCs. So total seven. Now I am teaching you the tumors of WBCs. So before that I should teach you how WBCs are formed in the bone marrow. I am teaching you first hematopoiesis. Now you will ask me, ma'am, why studying hematopoiesis is necessary before starting leukemias and lymphomas? You should know, what is leukemia and lymphoma basically? Does anyone know what is leukemia? What is lymphoma? Leukemia and lymphoma are the tumors of precursors of WBC. So what are the precursors of WBC? It is not the thing that these WBCs, neutrophils, eosinophils, basophils, monocytes, eosinophils, these are formed directly from our bone marrow. So there are some precursors. They are formed from hematopoietic stem cells. And from the stem cells, multiple precursors are there and then these are formed. So leukemias and lymphomas are the tumors of their precursors. So before studying the tumor, you should know their precursors. You should know the names of their precursors. Then you will have a better understanding what is leukemia, what is lymphoma, in which type of leukemia, in which type of lymphoma, which type of precursor is in excess. So that is my idea behind teaching you. So as I have told you, WBCs are of two types, granulocytes, agranulocytes. Just give me 1 minute. Okay, so granulocytes and agranulocytes, as I have told you, granulocytes are of three types, neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil. You can see in the theory also. So neutrophil is also known as polymorph. Many students have this confusion. Polymorph and neutrophil is one and the same thing. You can see the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm has granules. The granules are pink or purple color. Second is eosinophil. The granules are brick red color. And basophil, the granules are dark blue or black color. And the rest two are agranulocytes, that is lymphocytes and monocytes. These do not have granules in their cytoplasm. So agranulocytes are of two types. The lymphocytes again of two types, T lymphocyte and B lymphocyte. So these are the cells. So I will teach you how WBCs are formed in the bone marrow first. So all these are formed in the bone marrow. So imagine a bone marrow, just a second, okay. So just imagine a bone marrow, this is the bone marrow. So all these cells are formed inside the bone marrow. This is the bone marrow. The precursor of all the cells which give rise to all these cells, the seven types of cells, is hematopoietic stem cell. HSC, hematopoietic stem cell. From hematopoietic stem cell, RBCs are formed. From this cell only, platelets are formed. And from this cell only, all seven types of WBC are formed. So he is the grandfather of all cells. He is the father, he is the precursor, ultimate precursor of all cells is hematopoietic stem cell. It is pluripotent cell. So you can see here, this is hematopoietic stem cell here. And from this, all the seven types of cells are formed ultimately. So the phenomenon of formation of all these cells, RBC, WBC and platelet from a hematopoietic stem cell, the phenomenon is known as hematopoiesis. Hematopoiesis. Poiesis means formation, hemato means blood. Blood formation is bone marrow. So all of them are formed from hematopoietic stem cells. Hematopoietic stem cells are pluripotent cells because they are at the apex of hierarchy. They are at the apex of hierarchy. So from this only, this is at the apex. all the cells in the blood, RBC, platelet, and the five type of WBC. All cells are formed from this cell only. So they are at the apex of hierarchy. They have two properties. Hematopoietic stem cells have two properties. Number one, pluripotency. These are pluripotent. That's why they give rise to RBC also, all WBCs also, platelet also. That's why these are pluripotent or totipotent cells. Number one. And they have the capacity of cell renewal. They just do mitosis and cell division, and they have the capacity of, so ये अपने आप में divide होते जाएंगे और इनमें से सारे तरह के cell बनते जाएंगे. All RBC, WBC and platelets are formed from hematopoietic stem cells. So how they are formed? The phenomenon is known as hematopoiesis. That is my first lecture today. Now after teaching hematopoiesis, I will teach you the tumors. So it will be fun for you. All leukemias and lymphomas. So you have to understand the precursors, the intermediates in between. Hematopoietic stem cells से लेके neutrophils तक बीच में क्या क्या है? What is there in the middle? All the neutrophils are formed from hematopoietic stem cells. Monocytes are formed from hematopoietic stem cells. Lymphocytes are formed from hematopoietic stem cells. But what are the intermediates in between? So that is my idea to teach you about 140-minute lecture on hematopoiesis. So I'm starting with hematopoiesis. Now, in hematopoiesis, the first cell, as I have told you, is hematopoietic stem cell. So hematopoietic stem cell differentiate into two type of stem cells, two other type of stem cells. The first is lymphoid stem cell, the second is myeloid stem cell. Myeloid is also known as non-lymphoid or tri-lineage. I will teach you, don't worry. So can you see, this is the hematopoietic stem cell. You can see here, this is the hematopoietic stem cell. From this hematopoietic stem cell, either myeloid stem cell is formed or lymphoid stem cell is formed. So total how many things you have to form in the blood? In the blood total how many things you have to form? Just a second. So in the blood, how many cells are present? How many type of cells are present in the blood? So in the blood, we have RBCs, we have platelets, and we have five type of WBCs. You know the five type of WBCs, that is neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil, these are granulocytes, monocyte and lymphocyte, these are non-granulocyte. Now listen, please everyone concentrate here, please everyone. Now from this, just eliminate lymphocyte. Apart from lymphocyte, the rest four types of WBC with platelet with RBC, all of them are formed from myeloid stem cell. Stem cells are of two types. All of them, ye hematopoietic stem cell, this is hematopoietic stem cell at the apex, hematopoietic stem cell. It is differentiated into two stem cells, myeloid stem cell and lymphoid stem cell. Lymphoid stem cell. So lymphoid stem cell is forming only one cell, lymphocyte. As the name indicates, lymphoid stem cell is forming lymphocyte. Rest all the cells, the remaining WBC, neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil and monocyte, all platelets and all RBCs are formed from myeloid stem cells. Since myeloid stem cells is forming RBC also, platelet also and maximum WBC, except one WBC, rest all the WBC is formed from myeloid stem cells. That's why it is known as trilineage. Trilineage stem cells. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. So trilineage means because it is forming RBC also, platelet also, and all WBCs except lymphocytes. So that is the basic idea. You should understand the two series: lymphoid series, myeloid series. Lymphoid series में सिर्फ lymphocyte बनेंगे. Myeloid series में lymphocyte को छोड़के बचे हुए WBC, सारे RBC और सारे platelet बनेंगे. So myeloid series is trilineage series and lymphoid series is monolineage series. It is forming only lymphocyte. The ratio between the two series in bone marrow is 1:3. You understood this? Yes or no? So 1:3. 1:3 because this is forming only one thing and this is forming three things. So 3:1 or 1:3. So it is myeloid to lymphoid ratio is 3:1. This is normal myeloid to lymphoid ratio. So again, an important MCQ. So you can see this in the diagram also. See this in the diagram. Listen, everyone. So can you see, this is a lymphoid stem cell. It is forming only lymphocytes. B lymphocyte, T lymphocyte. That is lymphocyte along with natural killer cells. So it is forming only lymphocyte. Lymphocyte, that is B or T, dono banayega. And you can see, this is a myeloid stem cell. So it is forming RBC. It is forming platelet. You can see, this is RBC. This is platelet. And it is forming the remaining four WBC. That is neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil and monocyte. Have you got it? This is the basic idea. So this is what I have taught you till now. This is what. So from lymphoid series, lymphocytes are formed, T and B. And from myeloid series, which is known as trilineage series, RBCs are formed, platelets are formed एंड रिमेनिंग WBCs. अब रिमेनिंग WBC में कौन कौन बच गया? रिमेनिंग WBC में चार बच गए, तीन तो ग्रेनुलोसाइट, दैट इज इओसिनोफिल, बेसोफिल एंड न्यूट्रोफिल, एंड एक ग्रेनुलोसाइट में से मोनोसाइट. सो इट इज नोन एज ग्रेनुलोसाइट मोनोसाइट सीरीज, नॉट लिम्फोसाइट. तो अलग हो गया यहां से. सो दैट इज द थिंग. सो यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड, एंड दीज आर द इंटरमीडिएट, दीज आर नॉट फॉर्म डायरेक्टली. इट इज नॉट द थिंग कि स्टेम सेल से डायरेक्टली ये बनेंगे. सो दीज आर द इंटरमीडिएट्स इन बिटवीन. So for WBC, you should learn the intermediates in between, then you will have a better understanding of leukemias and lymphomas. So let's see, I will come on WBC before that, just see the intermediates of RBC. So as I have told you, RBC, erythroid series, RBCs are formed from myeloid stem cell. The myeloid stem cell, the first cell is formed, is pro-erythroblast. Then early erythroblast, intermediate erythroblast and late erythroblast. Early, intermediate and late, then reticulocyte and then RBCs. So early erythroblast, also the mnemonic is BPO. Listen now, the mnemonic is BPO. Early erythroblast is known as basophilic erythroblast, intermediate erythroblast is known as polychromatic erythroblast, and late erythroblast is known as orthochromatic. So basophilic, polychromatic, orthochromatic, BPO, basophilic, polychromatic, orthochromatic, early, intermediate, late. The three blasts, it will give rise to reticulocyte and ultimately RBC will come in the blood. These all intermediates are present in the bone marrow. Blood mein sirf RBC aa raha hai. Iske pehle ke precursors are present in the bone marrow. Give me a thumbs up if you got this. This is how RBCs are formed. But today I am not teaching you RBCs, anemias. I am teaching you leukemias. So my basic concern to teach you is WBC formation. How WBC are formed in the bone marrow. So this is RBC you have already seen in the bone marrow. This is the bone. You can see the bone marrow here. You can see the bone marrow here. In the bone marrow, this is the first cell, proerythroblast. Then early. This is early. This is intermediate. And this is late erythroblast. Early is known as basophilic. Intermediate is known as polychromatic. Late is known as orthochromatic. So early, intermediate, late, you can write BPO. Basophilic, polychromatic. So very confusing MCQs are there based on it. But don't get confused if you know the mnemonic BPO. Done. And then reticulocytes are formed. And then RBCs are formed. And they will come in the blood. Everyone give me a thumbs up again. Is my voice is echoing again? Is there a echo again in the voice? Are you not hearing clear? My audio is not clear. There is echo again. There is echo. Okay. Let me sort it out. This. Give me 1 minute. Just give me 1 minute. I will continue it. If there is echo. So granular pulses. I'm starting how WBCs. This is how RBCs are formed. So let me tell you now how WBCs are formed now. So the WBC formation, as I have told you, there are two steps in WBC formation. Granular pulses. In granular pulses, neutrophils, eosinophils, and basophils are formed from myeloid series and monocyte macrophage series, in which monocytes are formed and lymphocytes are separate banenge lymphopoiesis mein. So let me start first granular pulses. In granular pulses, I will not teach you all. What I will teach you from this, how neutrophils are formed, how monocytes are formed, and how lymphocytes are formed. So I will teach you three. So you have to learn three flowcharts, the intermediates in between. I will not teach you basophil and eosinophil in detail because it is not very important and not in your syllabus. So you will understand how neutrophils are formed, the intermediates in between, how monocytes are formed, and how lymphocytes are formed. Lymphocytes are formed from lymphoid series, and monocytes and neutrophils are formed from myeloid series. So let's see myeloid series first, how neutrophils are formed. So the first precursor is myelomonoblast. From myelomonoblast, myeloblasts are formed, promyelocyte, myelocyte, metamyelocyte, bandforms and neutrophils. So these are the intermediates in between. So myelomonoblast, then myeloblast, then promyelocyte, myelocyte, metamyelocyte, band form and neutrophils. So this is the whole series. You have to learn it because when I will teach you leukemias, the two type of leukemias, you know what are the two types of leukemias, myeloid and lymphoid. So when I will teach you myeloid leukemias. In myeloid leukemias are again AML and CML, acute and chronic, the two types of myeloid leukemias. In AML, this is the cell which is coming in peripheral blood. All these are present in bone marrow only neutrophil is coming in the blood. Rest all are present normally in bone marrow. But when the precursors, which precursor? The blast is coming in the blood, it is known as AML. And when all the precursors are coming in the blood, it is known as CML. So you should know the list of these precursors. So let me tell you again, once again, we will revise it. What is the list of precursors? Who will tell me? How neutrophils are formed? What is the list of precursors? It is formed from, all of them are formed from hematopoietic stem cell. So this is hematopoietic stem cell. From hematopoietic stem cell, the first cell which is formed from hematopoietic stem cell is myeloblast. Then promyelocyte. Then metamyelocyte, then promyelocyte, metamyelocyte, then myelocyte, and band form, and then neutrophil. So these are the precursors. So ultimately in blood only, normally in blood only neutrophil is coming. Only neutrophil comes in blood. No other cell normally comes in blood, in you and in me. All other cells are present in bone marrow. They are present in bone marrow. These are the precursors of neutrophils. But when these precursors comes in blood, which precursor? Which precursor is coming in the blood? So when blast is coming in the blood, it is known as AML, AML, acute myeloid leukemia. And when all other precursors also come in blood, all precursors are coming in blood, it is known as CML, chronic myeloid leukemia. So you got the basics, how acute and chronic myeloid leukemia is occurring, how they are coming in the blood. Say yes or no, how they are coming in the blood. But why they are, the question arises, why they are coming in blood? They are coming in blood because of the mutations. There is occurring some mutations in the hematopoietic stem cells or in this blast. I will tell you the name of the mutations. Just suppose in CML, the name of the mutation, it is 922 translocation. In AML, it is 811 translocation. So there are multiple translocations, multiple point mutations are there. I will enumerate all of them when I will teach you separately all these leukemias. So because of these mutations, there is excessive mitosis or uncontrolled mitosis or proliferation of these precursors in the bone marrow, and they will be spilled in the blood. And the tumor is known as blood tumor or leukemia. So have you understood? Have you learned the sequence? So tell me the sequence again for neutrophils. Once again, you will tell me the sequence. So what is the sequence for neutrophils? What is the sequence for neutrophils? It is hematopoietic stem cell, the first cell, the apex cell. From it, myeloblast. Promyelocyte, metamyelocyte, and macromyelocyte, myelocyte, metamyelocyte, band form and neutrophils. So you have to learn the sequence, there is no escape. So that was about myeloid series. Now coming on, so you can see this in this diagram also. So let me use the highlighter. Okay. So you can see this is myeloblast. From hematopoietic stem cell, the first cell formed is myeloblast. Then promyelocyte, myelocyte, metamyelocyte, band form, and then neutrophil is coming in blood. So in blood only neutrophil is coming. Rest all the cells are present in bone marrow. I hope you got it. I hope. And these are the precursors. But during their development, you can see as we are moving further ahead. As we are moving from myeloblast to promyelocyte, as we are moving ahead, we can see they are becoming progressively, the cytoplasm, the nucleus is becoming progressively closer. See the nucleus of this, see nucleus of this, see nucleus of this cell, this cell, this cell. So nucleus become closer, they are losing their nucleus, and cytoplasm is losing its nucleus. See the cytoplasm of myeloblast and see the cytoplasm of rest of the cells. So the cytoplasm is losing the rest, the blue color. And the first granules which appears are known as azurophilic granules in the cytoplasm. And then rest of the granules are known as specific granules. So azurophilic granules are primary granules. Specific granules are secondary granules. Primary granules are present at which stage? Very important MCQ. They are present at this stage. They are present at promyelocyte. And from myelocyte onwards, specific or secondary granules are arising in the cytoplasm. All these are important MCQs. All these are important MCQs. Done. So azurophilic or primary or non-specific granules are present at promyelocyte stage, and specific and secondary granules are present at myelocyte stage. So you have to learn it. You have to learn it. So we have done how neutrophils are formed. Let me tell you how monocytes are formed. Then I will tell you how leukocytes are formed. Then we will start leukemias and lymphomas. So the second thing, how monocytes are formed. How monocytes. So this is the list. So this is the precursors. So the first cell is of course blast. From hematopoietic stem cell, it is myeloblast. Then promonocyte, monocyte, and monocyte is coming in blood. When it is entering the tissue, it is known as macrophage. We all know monocyte and macrophage is one and the same thing. So in blood, it is known as monocyte. In tissue, it is known as macrophage. And in bone marrow,
two precursors are there, bone marrow. It is monoblast and promyelocyte. So monoblast से promyelocyte bone marrow में बनेगा, promyelocyte से monocyte बनके blood में आएगा और monocyte जब tissue में चला जाएगा तो हम उसे macrophage कहेंगे. So this is the whole sequence. This is the whole sequence. In some leukemias which are monoblastic leukemias, monoblast will come in the blood. Normally monoblast do not come in the blood, but if it is coming in the blood, it is monoblastic leukemia. Done. So it is not in your syllabus, but I'm telling you. So the next thing. So we have understood the precursors of neutrophils. We have understood the precursors of monocyte. Now I will tell you the precursors of lymphocyte. Very, very, very important. So small sequence. The first cell is blast. Always the first cell is blast. From hematopoietic stem cell, the first cell is lymphoblast. Then prolymphocyte and then lymphocyte. So you can see this is lymphoblast. Then prolymphocyte and then lymphocyte. Ultimately lymphocyte is coming in the blood. If instead of lymphocyte this blast is coming in the blood, the leukemia is known as ALL, acute lymphoid leukemia. And when this mature lymphocyte is coming too much in the blood, it is known as CLL. So you should understand myeloid and lymphoid leukemias. So once this lymphocyte comes in the blood, this is the formation of lymphocyte. So all lymphocytes are formed in the bone marrow. Listen, I am telling you a very interesting thing. Listen. Everyone listen here. Okay, let me change the color. So all lymphocytes are formed in the bone marrow. Let me draw a bone marrow. This is the bone marrow. This is the hematopoietic stem cell, the first cell. From hematopoietic stem cell, lymphoblast is the first blast is formed. Lymphoblast, then prolymphocyte and then lymphocyte. So lymphocytes are formed in the bone marrow. They will come in the blood. The formation of lymphocyte takes place in the bone marrow. Of course, maturation takes place where? Now if maturation also takes place in the bone marrow, or maturation takes place in the thymus, depends. So there are two organs for maturation. Either maturation also takes place in the bone marrow or maturation takes place in the thymus. So two types of lymphocytes are formed, B lymphocyte and T. B for bone marrow. If maturation takes place in bone marrow, it is known as B lymphocyte. If maturation takes place in thymus, it is known as T. T for thymus. T, the first letter of thymus, T lymphocyte. So lymphocytes are of two types, B lymphocyte and T lymphocyte, depending on the organ of maturation, not organ of formation. Depending on organ of maturation. If they are maturing in bone marrow, it is B lymphocyte. If they are maturing in thymus, it is known as T lymphocyte. But formation of both of them takes place in bone marrow. Formation to bone marrow mein hi hota hai. Maturation kahan hota hai, us pe depend karta hai. So you can see here, maturation takes place in the bone marrow, it is B lymphocyte. Maturation takes place in the thymus, it is T lymphocyte. Then B and T are formed and they will grow the lymph node and will be arranged accordingly in the lymph node. Done. So that is the thing. So we have learned all. Give me a thumbs up if you got this basic concepts. So there are two types of blast. The first blast in myeloid series is known as myeloblast. From myeloblast, all the precursors are arising. And the first blast in lymphoid series is lymphoblast. So the myeloid leukemias, that is AML and CML, these are myeloid leukemias. In this myeloid leukemia, myeloblast is the cell which is coming in blood, leaving the bone marrow and it is coming in the blood. And in lymphoid leukemias, that is CLL and ALL, lymphoid leukemias, lymphoblast is the cell which is coming in the blood. So blast is coming in the blood, ultimately a blast, either myeloblast, the first cell there, or lymphoblast, the first cell there. Normally blasts are present in marrow. Till they are present in bone marrow, they are normal. If they leave marrow and they are coming in the blood, it is known as leukemia. Now, which blast is coming? Myeloblast is coming, myeloid leukemia. Lymphoblast is coming, lymphoid leukemia. Have you got it? Give me a thumbs up. I tried my best. So, when myeloid precursors are coming, myeloblast. When lymphoid precursors are coming, that is lymphoblast, it is lymphoid leukemia. So, that is the ultimate thing. So, that is what we are. So, you should differentiate the two types of blast. So this is how we differentiate the two types of blast. Let me show you. So this is how myeloblast and lymphoblast. So depending on the size, depending on the nucleus, depending on various things, we decide which type of blast it is. So I will tell you the details when I will teach you different type of leukemias in the next lecture. So that is the overview of today's leukemias and lymphomas. So ultimately how these are formed, I have told you. Any problem in understanding it? Anyone having any problem in understanding it? Say yes or no. Say something. At least say something. Just a second. So let me move ahead. If you don't have any problem, let me move ahead. Okay. Okay. So, yeah. One more thing I would like to tell you here is antigenic designation. The most difficult topic most of the students find. Antigenic designation. What do you mean by antigenic designation? All these precursors have peculiar antigen on their surface. And based on that, what antigen is present on what cell, they are identified. Now, cells, don't say now that I am this cell, I am pro-monocyte, I am monocyte, I am pro-lymphocyte, I am blast. So, based on the antigen present on their surface, we identify them. It is known as CD markers. So, the full form of CD45, CD34, you have heard it. So, the full form of CD, very few students knows it. It is cluster of differentiation. So, CD markers are there. So, I will tell you the list of CD markers for your MCQs in many exams, especially the AIIMS and NICT. These exams, these CD markers are really very important. And these are important nowadays for clinical scenarios also. So, CD34 is the marker of stem cell, hematopoietic stem cell. So, the hematopoietic stem cell, the ultimate apex cell is CD34 positive. You can see here, it is CD34 positive. Yes or no? So, it is CD34. See here, it is CD34. You can see. Yes or no? You can see. Can you see? This is CD34. It is present on hematopoietic stem cell. So, all hematopoietic stem cells are CD34 positive. Please learn it. Many times this MCQ is asked. Or it is coming in clinical scenarios. There is a cell in the bone marrow which is CD34 positive and it is coming in blood. That is, they are talking about leukemia. Stem cells are coming in the blood. So, CD34 is a marker of hematopoietic stem cell. Hematopoietic stem cell, the first cell. Stem cell is a marker CD34. And CD34. So, for CD34, ISCs are developed. Antibodies against CD34 we have developed by tagging it. And there are many cells in the slide. Now, you can see these all are cells in the slide. These all are. Now, which of them are hematopoietic stem cells? It is a biopsy. Which of them are hematopoietic stem cells? Bone marrow biopsy. So, I will put CD34 on it. So, the cells which will pick CD34 are stem cells. Rest of the cells are not stem cells. CD34 present only on hematopoietic stem cells. No other cells are CD34 positive. Please make a note of it. Done. The second cell which is CD marker which is important is CD45. 34 ke baad I am coming on 45. 45 is a marker which is present on all 7 WBCs. There are all 5 WBCs. All 3 granulocyte, neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil and monocyte and lymphocyte. So all WBCs, all 5 type of WBCs, whether granulocyte or agranulocyte, they have CD45 on it. So CD45 also known as leukocyte common antigen. LCA, the other name of CD45, because it is present on all WBCs. So CD45 is LCA. Done. So you can see these are the WBCs. These are various WBCs. This is granulocyte, this is monocyte, this is T lymphocyte, this is B lymphocyte, this is. So whatever WBC is it, CD45 is present on all of them. CD45 is a common marker for LCA. CD45 ka other name is LCA. Please learn it, it is LCA. Done. Now T cell. As I told you, lymphocytes are of two types. T lymphocytes if they are maturing in thymus and B lymphocytes if they are maturing in bone marrow. So what are the T cell markers? T cell. The markers which are present on T lymphocyte, what other cells have these markers? So CD1, just learn the list. CD3, CD4, 5, 8. 1, 3, 4, 5, 8. CD1, 3, 4, 5, 8. So you have to learn these are the T cells markers. Among them, CD3 is a PEN-T. It is present on all T cells. PEN-T marker is CD3. Please learn it. So can you see this is a T cell? These are the T cell. This is a T cell. On the T cell, you can see CD3, you can see CD4. And so these are the markers which are shown here on T cell. Coming on B lymphocytes, the marker for B lymphocytes. So CD10, 19, 20, 21, 23, 24 and 79A. So 10 cells, start from 10, then start from 19, jump to 19. 10 ke baad 19, 20, 21, 23, 24 and then jump to 79A. You have to learn it. Isme kuch samajhne ka nahi hai. I am giving you list together just to compile it and to learn it. All of them are B cell markers. From that, CD19 is a pen B cell marker. So you can see a B cell here. This is a B cell. You can see on the surface the various markers CD20, 22, 19, 79A. So these are the markers on B cell. Give me a thumbs up. Natural killer cell markers. So two markers specifically present only on NK cells. Natural killer cells. 16 and 56. Learn the numbers. Please learn the numbers. 16 and 36. And few markers present monocyte or macrophage. You know monocyte and macrophage is same cell. When it is present in blood, it is monocyte. When it is present in tissue, it is known as macrophage. So which markers are present? 11, 13, 14, 15, 33, 64. I know it is difficult to learn the numbers, but
I have to give this list to you people before solving MCQs and for clinical scenarios. Nowadays, there is an era of clinical questions. Yes or no? So in any clinical question, you have to take the clues. So these markers are given in the clues. There is a cell which is CD14 positive. So you have to understand they are talking about some monocyte or macrophage. There is a cell which is CD16 positive. So they are talking about natural killer cell. There is a cell which is CD19 positive. So they are talking about B lymphocytes. So you have to take these CD markers. Otherwise, one-liner MCQs can be framed from it. You know. So if you solve the past year papers, so from this topic you will get many questions based on these CD markers. So that is all about CD markers. This is the whole list which I have taught you till now. Yes or no, give me a thumbs up. So what are the T cell markers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. What are the B cell markers? 10, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 79, 8. What are the NK markers? Natural killer 16 and 56. What are the monocyte macrophage markers? 13, 14, 15 and 33. This I have already taught you. Few special things, extra things are also given in this table. You can see EBV receptors, Epstein Barr virus receptors, it is CD21. So CD21 is present on the tonsillar B lymphocyte. When Epstein Barr virus enters via mouth, it binds to CD21 receptor of B lymphocyte and it will cause Burkitt lymphoma. When I will teach you Burkitt lymphoma, I will mention the CD21 again. So I will revise you there also retrospectively ki CD21 yaad aaya, maine wahan list mein bataya tha. So EBV binds with CD21 of the B lymphocytes in the tonsils. Please learn it. So that is EBV marker. Platelet. ये तो सारी ब्रेन डिजीज की बात हुई. Platelet पे कौन सा मार्कर होता है? CD41. Yes. And Langerhans cell, it is CD1. So learn the list. All of them already MCQs occurred or they appeared in the past papers. So new MCQs can be any time framed from this or clinical questions can be framed using these CD markers. So that is the list of CD markers. I hope you people are ready for the polls. Yes, for CD marker is an antigen, you can say. It is antigenic designation only. So, ready for the polls? I will launch 2-3 polls only here and you have to answer among ABCD. So, read the question. Which among the following is the PEN-T lymphocyte marker? PEN-T lymphocyte marker. So, is it CD2, CD3, CD19 or CD25? Just now I have told you the list. What is the correct answer? ABCD. Just write your answer in the chat box, in the comment box. A, B, C, D. Which is the correct answer here? What is the correct answer here? Which of the following is a PEN-T lymphocyte marker? Yes. So most of you are correct. Of course, the correct PEN-T lymphocyte marker I have told you, the correct answer here is B. That is CD3. So you can see here from all of these, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 3 is there in the option. These all are T cell markers and from them, 3 is the PEN-T. बाकी कोई ऑप्शन भी नहीं है 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. यू हैव टू लर्न. दिस इज द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. सो बी सेल मार्कर्स आर ऑल एक्सेप्ट. द क्वेश्चन कंटेन्स एक्सेप्ट. बी सेल मार्कर्स आर ऑल एक्सेप्ट. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट अ बी सेल मार्कर. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट अ बी सेल मार्कर. सो CD19, CD20, CD10 एंड CD135. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट अ बी सेल मार्कर. यस, हु विल टेल मी? Not. The question contains except. Yes. So most of you are right. So you have learned the list, I think. So the correct answer among these is CD125. Because in the list, 10, 19, 20, 21, 22, 24, these are there in the list. So CD35 is not there in the list. So the correct answer here is D because except is asked in the question. So you can see the B cell markers here. 10 is there, 19 is there, 20 is there in the list. So rest of the three options, 10, 19 and 20 is there in the list. But 135 is not there in the list. So learn these B and T cell markers. You cannot afford missing it. So this is the next question in front of you. Again the same question with different options. Same question with different options. All of the following are B cell markers except. Again the question contains except. Question is same. But options are different. CD15, CD21, CD19, CD24. A, B, C, D. Four options are in front of you. Yes. Who will tell me? Who will tell me the correct answer? Yes, you people are right. Nandini, Parag, Janvi, you all are right. So what is the correct answer among these? Who will tell me? Yes. What is the correct answer? All of the following are B cell markers except? Yes. So A is the correct answer here. CD15 is not there in the list. And rest all you can see in the list. So rest all options 21, 24 and 19. So it is 21, 19 and 24 is also there. So they are there in the list. So you can see. So that was all about the CD markers. Now, before starting leukemias and lymphomas, one more thing, you should know the normal WBC counts. I am concerned with WBCs now because I am teaching you leukemias and lymphomas. What is normal count in human beings? So in adults, do you know it is 4000 to 11000? Because in leukemias, I will tell you there is either leukopenia or leukocytosis. So you should know leukopenia and leukocytosis ka meaning. Leukopenia when the counts are less than 4000 and lymphocytosis and leukocytosis when the counts are more than 11000. So counts will be in lakhs. In CML it is 2 lakh. Instead of 11000 WBC become 2 lakh. So counts are more than at least 50000. So 50000 se to zyada hi hote hain count and it can be 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakh. So leukocytosis is a feature of all leukemia. So you should understand first what is normal count. So in adults learn it is 4000 to 11000. For 11000 se to zyada hi rahenge, 50000 se bhi zyada rahenge and usually in lakhs. In leukemias I am talking about. Yes or no? And what about the different 5 type of WBCs? No? So these are the 5 type of WBCs. So from among this 11000, how many are neutrophils? It is 40 to 75% of 11,000, that is 2,000 to 7,000. How many are leukocytes? It is 20 to 50%. Monocytes are only 2%. Eosinophils is 1 to 6%. Basophil is less than 1%. So these are the different. This is known as differential leukocyte count, DLC. This was TLC. Total kitna hai? Total mein se differential kitna hai? TLC and DLC you should know. So these are the 5 type of WBCs I have finished yet. I have finished the 5 type of WBCs. So neutrophils are also known as polymorphs, lymphocyte, monocyte, eosinophil, basophil. You know how they are formed from the bone marrow. Now I will teach you their tumors. Their tumors means they are leukemias and lymphomas. Does anyone know the difference between leukemia and lymphoma? Both of them are okay blood cancers or blood or reticular system cancers. So what is the basic difference between them? Does anyone know what are leukemias? What are lymphomas? Then I will teach you what are the classifications of leukemias and lymphomas and then we will start one by one the various leukemias and lymphomas. Do you know? Okay. I am just stopping here. I will continue the lecture just after 15 minutes. So just as sharp, listen, sharp 10 o'clock. Don't go anywhere. Just have a cup of tea and coffee again. Come again. At 10 o'clock we will start with lymphomas. First I will teach you lymphomas then leukemias. So lymphomas, I will start with Hodgkin's lymphomas. So first I will tell you the difference between leukemia and lymphoma, then the classification of leukemia and lymphoma. From lymphoma we will start Hodgkin's lymphoma and next lecture will be a little bit longer, it will be 1 hour or more than that. And I will finish Hodgkin's lymphoma, all the theory as well as MCQs, the various types of RS cells, the various types of Hodgkin's lymphoma, all MCQs that can be framed from it. It is 5-star important topic, don't dare to miss it. Please come back after 15 minutes. Have a cup of coffee, refresh yourself, come back. So we will continue this topic after 10 minutes. Done. So I am just handing this link. Join another link, Hodgkin's lymphoma wala link on the YouTube. You will get it. I am just handing it.